What are we going to order? I don't know.
I'm thinking Timbits.
Timbits. Yeah. I'm Vince from NadoandVince, YouTube.com. Today we're going to be taking our tank to the Tim Hortons drive-thru. This is probably the first time we've actually taken it out anywhere. We kind of just had it at home and we've been working on it. So hard work is finally starting to pay off a little bit. What do you think of it, Nate?
I think it's going to be my new commuter.
It's actually not terrible on gas. I think we probably get like 20 liters for 100K. It's not that bad. There we go. I'll just clean everything up and we're good to go.
That's why it gets such good fuel economy, because we push it most of the way.
Woo! There's always a lot of work to do. Ended up just taping on a logo last second.
And we should weld a little
little flake holder?
Yeah, something that can hold like a broomstick.
Yeah.
We definitely save money on tape.
Canada flag, well, we live in Canada and we want people to know that tanks are legal in Canada. So that was kind of just a last minute thing. I think it worked out actually. The tape looks kind of interesting.
Yeah. Looks like Operation Lunch Run is a go.
You start them up and we'll be up. All of a sudden, just the one track wasn't spinning too nice. I thought, oh, what the heck is going on? Is it just sliding? And then we hopped out and I took a look at what was going on.
Sprockets are off.
All of them?
Yeah. Come on over here, give me a hand.
What do you need?
Do you have a hammer? It's busted and I just got into the drive-thru. There's cars behind me, they're trying to get through, and hope it doesn't just end up being that we end up blocking the drive-thru and they get all mad because some teenagers decided to park a tank in their drive-thru.
Something new every day with this thing.
What the heck? Here, you can just probably start it on and then we'll bicycle.
I was worried about the Tim Hortons getting mad at us because we were blocking their drive-thru, and if they got mad, we'd have to leave and then we wouldn't be able to do what we were trying to do. But, you know, we had to deal with it. It broke at the worst time, too. It was right at the entrance of the thing. We were holding people up.
As the guy thinks that we should just, like, put it in neutral, push it out of the way.
He's probably right. Okay, we could
push it out of the way.
Yeah, let's push it quickly. Yeah. It's funny how there's always generally, like, one problem. And we can always fix that problem. And while this tank isn't perfect, you know, we work on it and we fix it, but I think a lot of the repairs that we do in this, they teach us a lot about how to get through these problems and how to like fix these things as they happen and just keep adjusting. And I mean, we want to build another tank, we want to build lots of other really cool stuff, and just learning to do the repairs and fix the issues on this tank is definitely going to help us a lot in the future.
Gonna have to pull this track off, put it back on the sprocket.
You do what you gotta do, it's a homemade tank. There's no manual we can look in. It's all up here.
We're taking off the track. That used to take us like 2 hours or so, but now we've kind of figured it out so we can just take it all apart and get it back together pretty fast now.
Look at this, you guys.
It's really cool.
We're gonna go through the drive-thru, but we've gotta fix it quickly because it broke just before that, but we'll have it up in the wrecking pretty soon.
Thank you so much.
We're
super
guys. There we go.
Get more publicity sitting here broken than we are moving. We put the track back on, linked it back up. We refastened the guide wheels that's on the track there. And that was all we had to do.
We fixed it up pretty fast, 20 minutes. And we're up and running and gotten pretty fast at it now. We're good to go. Hopefully nothing breaks. I'll just drive easy. Get this thing going.
Great. Good.
Ready? Yeah, I'm good.
Timbits, please, and 2 medium ice caps, please.
Sure.
Yeah. We ordered 2 ice caps and a box of 20 Timbits. Something really iconic.
How much is that?
We built it. Yeah.
Never know what people are gonna think, but I think a lot of people really enjoyed seeing the tank and hopefully made their day.
We went right through. I was a little bit worried that the staff might get mad at us for holding up the line, but they were pretty excited to see us. And the cops didn't show up, so that's a win.
Well, our mission was to get through the Tim Hortons drive-thru and order some food and not break down. That didn't really happen, but does it really count if we broke down, if we fixed it on site and made it through? So I'd say it's a successful mission.
Oh, Vinny.
It vibrated and we dumped the drink out.
Such as yours. It was an accident.
Oh, it was gonna be really good and then I dumped my drink. Now I know, it vibrates really bad. That shelf that I put it on, there's a bit of a shelf on the side with the controls. It's not safe. Any drinks just kind of rattle, and then right off the edge onto the floor. So maybe we'll have to put cup holders in. Another improvement. Well, the drink's coming out the back now, the one that we dumped on the floor.
Sprung a leak. I didn't know there was a hole in our floor. That's good to know.
Well, the Timbits were really good.
Yeah, I'll talk to Vince for a second.
We made it through. I got my breakfast, so I'm good. Yeah, I don't think that could have gone any better than it did. The track had a couple issues with it. We fixed it as we saw fit, but it was really fun. It went really well. It's good to see that it actually works well on pavement, and it's kind of hard to miss with all these normal-looking cars everywhere. There's a lot of people that noticed it.
Very well.
Thanks.
One of the
NATO, he really wants to build a bigger tank, to build a full-size tank. We'll see if we do that. And we're planning on building a gun, put an airsoft gun in that tank, and maybe potato cannon sort of style airsoft gun thing. And we're planning on playing a little bit of airsoft. We'll see how that turns out. Hopefully it doesn't break mid-game. Otherwise, we're going to be doing some field repairs, and not as easy while you're being shot at. So see how that goes.
You have to take the tank into battle, I mean. That's kind of what it's for. So I think that's probably going to be what's next.
Yeah, I'd say today's definitely a big success.
I was totally impressed too. That was pretty epic.
Yeah. Thanks, Moses.
Well, if you like the video, maybe check out our other videos, give us a subscription, and maybe hit the like button for us.
There's some people, some pretty cool cars, and some pretty cool vehicles, and some really cool tanks, but very few people make their own tanks, so that's what makes this one special, even though it breaks all the time.
It's not just any hunk of junk, it's our hunk of junk.
Yeah, for sure. And it'll go 20 kilometers an hour, so if you're in traffic, it doesn't really matter anyway.
Yeah, of course.
You get to ride in style.
It was engineered by the best, well, how could it be any? How could it be worse than a car?
And if there's anybody that's bugging you, just drive over them, you know?